This video is going to go over conditional aborts in Behavior Designer. Now, conditional aborts are very similar to the observer aborts in Unreal Engine 4. So if you've used those before, then you should already know how these work. Conditional aborts are basically an optimization done so that the behavior tree does not need to be reevaluated every single frame. There's some documentation that's written on conditional aborts as well, and that's available online. So if you watch the overview video, you'll recognize this scene, and basically what we're doing is we have this capsule that will be moving forward, and as soon as it sees this cube, we want it to start chasing it. So we have a seek task that will seek a point out in the distance at distance 00300. And then we have another branch that will determine if it can see the cube, and as soon as it can see the cube, it will start seeking towards it. So let's go ahead and set abort type to none right now, so we have no conditional abort set up, and we'll go ahead and hit play. We can see that the very first frame, the capsule could not see the cube, so this can see object task returned failure, and since we have a selector at the root task, it then started running the seek task. We go ahead and hit play. If we pause it right here, it looks like this cube should be within view. So we ideally want this seek task to start running, so it'll start seeking towards the cube instead of out in the distance. But as you can see, it just completely ignores it. And now it's just going to its point out in the distance. We can change that by setting an abort type of lower priority. Any composite type has this abort type option. So the sequence has it, this selector has it, and anyone has it. There are four different options. None, which is what we just saw, self, lower priority, and bolt. Bolt is basically self and lower priority. What lower priority means is it will abort if the conditional task within the current branch changes and a branch that's lower priority than the current branch is running. So that's a little bit confusing, so let me just go ahead and hit play and we'll see what happens. So at the very start, this hasn't changed at all. The capsule cannot see the cube, so can see object returns failure, and now this seek task starts running. However, in the background, you obviously can't see it, but this can see object task is continuously to be reevaluated since a lower priority branch, or in this case, a lower priority task, is currently running. So as soon as the can see object status changes, it will then abort this seek task. So as soon as we hit play, the cube then becomes within view. It aborted the seek task, the branch that's lower from the current branch, and this can see object task returns success, which causes this seek task to also return success, and now it's going to keep playing. And it will continue on until it eventually gets it. So that was the lower priority abort type. For the self abort type, we need to move the capsule a little bit closer to the cube. So the very first frame, it will see the cube. So the very first frame, can see object will return success, and then it will start seeking towards the cube. Because we have an abort type of self, it will continuously to reevaluate this can see object since this seek task is within the same branch. So this is a branch right here. And as soon as the capsule cannot see the object while it's seeking, it will abort it and move on to the next branch. So I think there will be one case when this happens. So just started the tree, can see object, could see the object since we basically placed the capsule right in front of the cube, and now it's starting to seek the cube. So if we go ahead and hit play, I think it will be right about here. Yes, wow, that was pretty good. Right about there, the can see object task could no longer see the cube because it was behind it. Since we have a conditional abort of self, it aborted it, and then it just returns failure, and now it's running whatever is next. In this case, since we have the selector, it will run the next child since the first child returned failure. And now it starts seeking the point 00300 out in the distance. The last abort type is a combination of both of them. And for that, we will move him back to his original spot, and we'll go ahead and hit play. When it starts, it will be exactly like what happened before, where can see object, obviously cannot see the object yet, so it will seek it. However, since we have a abort type of both, it's continuously to reevaluate this can see object task. So as soon as it becomes within view, it should then pick this branch up and start running the seek task. So let's see if that works. And okay, so now that the cube is within view, it's now seeking towards it. Now, just like when we had this abort type of self, it is still reevaluating the can see object because it's still within the same branch. So now it's basically checking for an abort type of self. And so as soon as the cube cannot see it, looks like he's a little bit to the left of it. Yeah, we can see here the cube is no longer within its field of view. It then returns, or the conditional abort triggers, and now it returns and runs the next branch. And so now it's just going to seek towards the point out in the distance. So hopefully that gives a pretty good overview of what conditional aborts are. They're tricky at first, but once you use them a little bit, they're really powerful and make things a lot easier to do.